We're in the Tar Heel State in the city of Chapel Hill for this exciting matchup at Keenan Memorial Stadium. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. He's to the 20. Gets to about the 24-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Fires out to his receiver. That'll be a gain of 3 yards.
You know, this veteran wide receiver is not always easy to stop, so that's a good job here by the defense to slow him down.
Steps up in the pocket and sacked.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
From their own 21-yard line, third down. And he's tackled around the 36-yard line. On third and long, they get the first down, but was it close?
Close or not, what a relief it is to the quarterback to have a new set of downs to work with.
They'll bring him down around the 38-yard line. Taken down around the 46-yard line. So the pass is complete for an 8-yard gain and a first down.
And still, this gunslinger hasn't missed a receiver yet on this drive.
He's taken down right around the 46-yard line. After a decent run up the gut. Wide out makes the first down catch. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. The 19-yard line.
Well, if this defense keeps taking chances with these blitzes, sure, they may get to the quarterback once in a while, but they also are giving up some big plays like that one right there.
Throws to the receiver, and he's got it again. Tackle made at the 6. Out to the tailback on the screen. Nice move, and he scores. He makes the PAT. So an 11-play, 75-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
And down he goes at the 28-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Ready?
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
And they make the stop around the 50-yard line. Incomplete, broken up.
That was a heads-up play by the corner, but it would have never happened if the receiver would have come back to the ball instead of waiting for it to fall into his lap.
From midfield, second down. Quick strike to the receiver. He's tackled at the 41. Run and he's brought down. Throws, and that one's gonna hit the ground incomplete. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
Yeah, and that's a throw he should make every single time.
From the 37-yard line, second down. Caught, big hit. He's going to lose yardage. He's looking for six. No, incomplete.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Kicks away. That's a tough break there for the kicker. Still, our score, 7-0, North Carolina. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
There's a strike complete. Brought down at the 45-yard line. North Carolina up 7 points. Now he tries to buy some time. And down he goes around the 39-yard line. And they'll get him in the backfield. Down and they need to get it down to the 35.
Too little, Cupcake. Number 16's coming. Check Mike. Check Mike.
Three. He's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. They lose four there.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Big kick here to try to pin the offense deep in their own territory. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He's out to the 30, fires it out. And he's tackled at the 31-yard line. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Nowhere.
second down.
Right around the 40.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Complete. He's got room. And he's taken down.
Right around the 34.
The receiver found a hole in the zone and turned it into a first down.
No matter what type of defensive coverage you have, there are always going to be holes. The best thing you can do is make those holes small so the quarterback can't get the ball in there.
Scrambling around. He guns it. This one will fall incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34. He's going to try and scramble. Decides to slide.
Roger, Roger. 24 is the mic. You better be afraid of me. You better be afraid of me.
Shift, shift. Nice run there.
Makes it out to about the 13. He laterals the ball. And he shoved out of bounds at the 12-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Gets to about the 11-yard line. He's taken down at the 3-yard line. A long ways yet to go, but at the end of one, North Carolina's lead is a touchdown. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. The Terrapins had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Catches it, and he's punished. That's 4 yards on the play.
Good job by the quarterback to put the ball right in the hands of the big tight end there.
Kicks up, and they tack on 3 points. Maryland is ready to kick it away. It's fielded at the 2. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. North Carolina is up 4. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Watch the run, watch the run. Check back 16, check back 16. Check, check.
Looking for his man, incomplete. About 4 yards away here on third down. Look at his scramble now. He can't get away from the pressure.
I think this defensive end is doing a great job of getting after the quarterback, not only with the sack in this case, But it seems like the entire game he's done a good job of creating pressure, making this quarterback feel him, and almost giving him happy feet back there. He doesn't seem to be in rhythm and almost seems to be throwing the football, feeling the pressure and almost creating nerves on the quarterback.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. And he muffed it. And he's tackled at the 49-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Up the middle for a nice game. Makes it to the 37. They lose 3 yards there.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 40. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Fires out quickly to the tailback, and he's hit before he can go anywhere. About 6 yards on the play.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
He launches one for the end zone. Can't connect. So it's fourth down. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. It's up. And it's wide right. No good. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. North Carolina holds a four-point lead. He steps out at about the 43-yard line. Now he's scrambling.
Well, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack, and somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
From their own 43-yard line, it's third down. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Turner is back deep to return the punt. Made at the 21. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Makes it to the 22-yard line. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
From their own 17-yard line, it's second down.
Kill.
Pass is caught, the defense lays him out. A 5-yard gain.
You don't have to go deep every play to be successful. They got 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good gain.
Looks middle, got his back, and they hit him in the backfield. Newsom, the return man. Newsom fields at the 44, tackle at the 46-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
North Carolina is up by 4. Makes the catch, and look out. He's out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackle at about the 25-yard line.
Tell you something, I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Nicely.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And he adds the extra point.
A nice 5-play, 47-yard drive. And a touchdown as a result.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of center.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he'll return this one from the 7. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out. Fires left side. Tackle made at about the 45.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them. 24 is the mic.
Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield. So it's 2nd and 12. Ball on the 44-yard line.
Hey, watch that. Hey, watch the ball. Go four.
He's tackled at the 48-yard line. He lets it fly. And he's got his receiver. It's the sophomore.
This secondary better tighten it up if they're going to slow down this drive.
Now it's 1st and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass.
Hey, kill, kill, kill!
Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball.
Right left, right left. Down, down.
Boone takes a handoff. And they make the stop at the 7.
Man left, man left. Three down, three down. 3-4 is the mic.
They work the right side, and there is nothing going there. It's fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights. The Terrapins running back taken out earlier, sidelined with that injury. However, it looks like he's going to be able to come back in this game. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Taken from the 3-yard line, brought down at the 22. The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
He put the ball in there perfectly that time.
Let me tell you, this kid has impressed me all day with the touch on his passes. That's a good-looking throw there.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll have a chance to take a second look at it and determine if he really was in bounds when he caught the ball.
Well, the side judge was standing right there, so I'd be surprised if he missed that call.
Well, I know the receiver isn't too happy, but they got it right after the review. No catch. North Carolina holds an 8-point advantage. Flips it, middle to the running back. And down he goes at about the 33-yard line. From their own 33-yard line, first down. He's got to throw it in a hurry. And he's level at the 43-yard line.
There you go. Good read by the quarterback to give the offense a new set of downs. If the defense wants to line up and man, work that slant route until they stop it.
He's looking for 6. Missed him.
I know that this quarterback and wide receiver were very confident they'd be able to execute this play. They worked all week long in practice on this play. The problem is the wide receiver got too close to the boundary, just didn't give himself or the quarterback's throw much of a chance to make the reception.
Incomplete, almost picked off. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 33. Looks for his running back, incomplete. North Carolina is hoping to make this a 2-score game. He gets it up, and this is no good. He didn't have the leg for it. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. They'll bring him down right around the 30. A heck of a play by the receiver.
We talk all the time about the emotions of college football. This play was definitely an emotionally charged play. What a way for the wideout to make a statement in this game.
The kick is up. And he nails the long field goal. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. And down he goes at the 32-yard line. Well, we've played a half of football. The Tar Heels lead is 5.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half, and boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us, and more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three. He's to the 20.
There we go, deep. That's the way to hit.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure, but they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
On the ground with the tailback. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. And he gets a yard on the run. He goes out of bounds.
Around the 30-yard line.
Defense was ready for it. Spangler is waiting for the snap. He's tackled at the 44-yard line.
Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
That's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
In your face.
First and 10. Ball on their own 29. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's taken down at the 33.
Here we go, D. Here I come again. Here I come again. Here I come again.
Mike 16. Mike 16.
He's taken down right around the 36-yard line. Slings it, and he's tackled at the 43.
Check back 16, check back 16. He's back, back, back.
Watch his flat, watch his
flat.
And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Steps out of bounds.
Right around the 48-yard line.
Larry. Eat it up. Mike 16. Mike 16.
You don't want none, baby. You don't want none. Hey. Hey, you want
none.
Throws it to the halfback on the screen. Brought down around the 48-yard line. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. gains his way to the 29-yard line. He has some room. Good open field tackle. Gets out to about the 42-yard line.
Roger, Roger. Hey, check Mike 21, Mike 21, check Mike 21.
It's just me and you. It's just me and you.
Throws incomplete. Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. Needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
Third down now, and they need to get it out to midfield. Going over the middle, intercepted. And he is drilled at the 49-yard line. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
Scramble, but he's sacked. From their own 46-yard line, second down. Tackles him hard at the 47. Quick toss.
Wait, Brett, this guy drops an interception, and what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Now here comes the offense, and you've got to wonder if that last interception's weighing on the quarterback's mind at all.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
Check, check.
Gets it. He's in space. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 30. That's a great tackle at the 29. Newsom is back to receive. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. Maryland's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie. I guess at least not today.
No, not today. They've played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. He's hit and taken down. Gets to about the 44-yard line.
You gotta move quick. You gotta move quick right here.
Tackle around the 35-yard line.
Get to the ball. Get to the ball.
gets out to about the 22-yard line.
Concentration lapse right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
From the 11-yard line, first down. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. He didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
He fights forward to about the 7. Shows some moves and he's in. And for Williams, he adds another TD catch to make it 2.
Man, this running back has really helped his passing game. Every time he's on the field, it's like having another receiver out there.
And he hits the PAT. A nice 7-play, 52-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
An amazing drive for this offense, outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
The score now, 21-9. Gathered in at the 6, tackle at the 23. North Carolina is continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives. Fires quickly, and it's picked off. And he hits him hard at the 31. From the 31-yard line, it's first down.
Mike 16, Mike 16. Green 9, green 9.
Throws it in a hurry. He's tackled at about the 25-yard line. Tackle made around the 20-yard line. And they make the stop at the 20. That's 3 down and 1 to go. North Carolina's lead is 12. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Roger, Roger!
Hey, check Mike 11, check Mike 11.
Let's go!
He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home, blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
Third and 12 coming up on this one. Ball on the 22-yard line. Fires out to his receiver. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Dives forward.
On the ball, on the ball.
and he adds the extra point. North Carolina is ready to kick it away. Turner takes it from the six. He's out to the 30. He lost the ball, scoops up the loose ball, and they bring him down at the 39-yard line.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
Throws a bullet over the middle, and down he goes at about the 21. A decent pickup on the pass play.
And I'll tell you what, the defense did everything they could here. Give credit to the quarterback for putting this ball where it had to be for his receiver to catch it. Great job.
And they hit him in the backfield.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
From the 23-yard line, it's second down. Catches it, and that's all. First and goal. Touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point.
A five-play, 39-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
From the five-yard line, at the 30, and he's taken down at the 33-yard line.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries.
Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. He's got to throw it in a hurry. And he can't get away from the pressure.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
It's now third down and long. 13 yards to go for the first down after the sack. Looks middle. Got his back. They'll bring him down.
About the 33-yard line.
A pickup of about three.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
Rowe will be the return man. They'll bring him down at the 37. And for Howell, he's been impressive throwing the football.
Well, this is an example of this quarterback just really being able to go out and show his competitive spirit. And each time he plays, he puts that out on display. You know, and I also think he's showing that he's a lot more athletic than people want to give him credit.
He'll lead them out for another drive here, looking to add to his numbers and to their lead.
They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
They just seem like they've been in the end zone time and time again. There's not much negative you can say about this performance.
And they got him for a loss. From their own 33-yard line, it's second down. North Carolina comes to the line holding that commanding lead. Passes to the left, and it's going the other way. And he's taken down at the 42. From the 42-yard line, first down. Sets up a screen, tailback's got it. He's taken down around the 32-yard line. He might want it all here, and does! He's all the way home! Touchdown! Kirk, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly, and again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
It was a textbook post route, and the pass was right on target. And he tacks on the extra point. Taken down at the 43-yard line. Quarterback couldn't maintain possession on their last drive. Let's see what he does here.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out. I wouldn't be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to...
Passes into tight coverage, and it's going the other way.
Quarterback has made some really careless throws, but you got to also give credit to the defense for being able to clean up the mess and create the turnovers.
From their own 28-yard line, first down. Over the middle to his tailback. And he's tackled around the 29-yard line. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Now he's scrambling. Slides down to the ground. And he's level at the 43. He heaves it deep. The defender had it and then dropped it. From their own 43-yard line, second down. He goes out of bounds at midfield. Out quick, it's picked off. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. Brought down around the 16-yard line.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 16. Just under 3 to go in regulation. And that sets them up for the first and goal. Run right and hit in the backfield. So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Right around the 2-yard line. So he decides to hold on to it, and that's going nowhere. Now he tries to buy some time. He's tackled at the 2-yard line.
Keep 15.
Quick strike to the receiver, touchdown. Clock keeper, just keep it moving for Kirk and I, will you? We want to get out of here. He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. It's been a tough outing for this quarterback, Kirby.
When you're putting your game plan together as an offensive coordinator, the one thing you're kind of counting on is the senior quarterback's going to avoid mistakes. That has not happened today. Hopefully he can put this behind him and just try to move forward for the rest of this game.
And I don't think anyone would want to switch places with him, having a lousy game in front of a crowd this fierce.
We're late in the fourth quarter. This game has been a blowout for quite some time, and Kirk and I are just looking to make our flights.
Under a minute left.
Makes it out to about the 36. Jacobs gets 8 yards on the play. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds. He lets it fly. Intercepted, and I think I can hear the fat lady singing. Got an opening.
Well, it's just one of those days for this offense. Already getting blown out, now another interception. Can you imagine that walk over to the sideline for these guys?
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Favorite play in football of your quarterback. Take a knee.
This one was never close today.
North Carolina, 42. Maryland, 16.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.